Hi everybody, and welcome to part 2 of the video log regarding what happened to the hardwood shad master. If you haven't seen part 1, I encourage you to follow the link up here to see that one first, as that is what happens up to this point. And if you don't know at all what we are talking about when referring to the hardwood master, there's also a link up here you can follow to see the movie about making hardwood masters. Well, let's get on with it. Well, with the mold you just saw me create, I was actually ready to go ahead and cast some lures, but I used the opportunity to use a bit of resin and create a mold from that mold to be able to produce more molds. And with that, I actually already produced 2 more molds. So now I have 3 molds in all, and when you're casting with soft plastic, it's just so much easier if you have a few molds to fill at each time, because there's a bit of wait time between each fill and each color. And if you have to just keep waiting all the time, it will take a lot of time. So more or less, I'll be able to produce 3 casts at the same time I know else use for one. So, well, now it's just time to get out to the shed and go ahead and cast some lures.
Actually, that wasn't completely truth. At this point, I already used the 3 molds to cast some shads and take them test fishing for a second day in the brackish waters. Throughout the day, I had a lot of contacts on the new shads, caught a handful of decent pike, and near the end of the day, I hooked up with a really nice fish. The fish was measured to 106 centimeters, therefore being another personal best for me. 2 personal bests on a new lure. I'm certain that this lure will always be in my tackle box.
I'm now getting ready to cast some lures, and I know of a few colors that will work well for the pikes. One is this one, which is motor oil, with some gold and black included. This is the one that was on the prototype baits as well, so I'm 100% certain that this will work well. Another color I'm fairly certain of is this one, which is root beer, with a bit of copper and a bit of gold in it as well. I will make these with a black back, and maybe some of them with a with a screaming orange tail, I think. But apart from that, I'll just get going. I'll now start to preheat some colors, and I'll only make one color at a time in all three molds, as this is more rational, and there's a quite some time between each color in the molds. Also, there's a bit of time between making layer one and layer two, so actually just heat one color up at a time. That will be the easiest. And I think I'll start with this one that works so well with the prototypes. Well, I won't be talking too much, just leaving a few clips, but well, out in the shed all afternoon casting shads, and I must say I'm fairly satisfied with the result. All in dark, maybe some would say a bit dull colors, but that's what work in the brackish waters. I have a few ones from more or less black, only the paddle is not, over some reddish transparent kinds, and over to the motor oil color that works so well for me in the test fishing. I have a lot of those as well. What remains now is to cut off the funnels and trim the lures nicely. After that, I'll wash them off with some dishwashing soap and maybe also a bit of alcohol before I paint them, for the paint to better stick to the lure. I'll at least paint eyes on most of them, but I might even paint some scales or something else. Who knows, I'll figure that out. But on to that later. Washed off and are ready to get painted, but before I get going, there's a few preparations I want to make. First of all, I'll use some of the metal mesh I usually paint scales through to create a scale printing mask. And to do that, to avoid damaging my original master that I would like to keep, I have made a few replicas of it using resin. So I have a resin copy of that one, and I will use that to bend this scale printing mesh around. That would be part one. Part two, I would like to take these and cut them in half and take them out in the shed and make some thermoformed stencils out of the plastic, so I can make some awesome patterns on the bodies and use those for painting. Apart from that, I've already made a little stencil here I will be using to create the angry eyes. I think that will be all for now, so just hang in and I'll show you how I do the different parts here. Okay, and first of all, I like to bend it so I can cover both sides at the same time. So I'll just bent this on the middle, just using the table here, more or less like that, and I will have to make it broader at some point, so this is where I might end up damage the master, so I will use the replica for this. Okay, and to help me along the way, I just grabbed a few small clamps here, as they can help me keep the mesh in place. Okay, and then I'll grab a plier, and up here I can start to make sure that a bit more difficult here at the bottom, but I'll try. Okay, and I'll just squeeze it along the side of the shad here, so when I put it around the soft bait, it will fit nicely around it, and it will be very easy for me to paint. Now I'm satisfied with the fitting. I might try to get them a bit closer out here, but I'll just do one thing. I will like to cut out for gill plates, and I'll just use a V-shaped cut here along the lines of the mesh. So I'll have a nice fitted gill plate there, and I'll see how that turns out, like that. I think it's okay. Maybe another one. I'm not sure if the gill plate should be bigger or not. Well, I don't think it matters. So, if I grab a shad here, and I should be able to place it inside this one. Nice and tight. And just grab it with this one and like that, and then I can easily paint the lure. Now that I've made the metal mesh to fit around the lures, I can just start cutting these into pieces, so I won't be needing the tail for any patterns, so I'll just cut that one off, and then cut along the center line to create two halves representing each side of the lure. Result of the terraforming, which has left me with two of each side. So now I'll just cut them out with a scissor, draw some interesting patterns on them with my marker here, and use my Dremel to grind out the markings I've made. And that way I will have some nice stencils for when I'm ready to start painting the shads. Just about ready to start painting, and as you can see, I have my scale masking ready. I have my stencil for the eyes ready, and the thermoformed masters stencils, I also have them ready. I've added a piece of tape at the top so I can easily flip up the template here and place the lure inside and just hold them together with my fingers or whatever needed. Then I can paint both sides and be done in a jiff with that. So those tools are ready as well. Also made this little drying rack. This is quite easy from a piece of cardboard and some leftover wood here. From this I can have the lures hanging and drying without touching each other or touching anything else. So that I also made. So now I'm ready. And I will only be painting simple patterns here. It is just a question of getting a few extra details on the baits. So it will be fairly simple, no shades and stuff. Just the eyes and patterns on some of them. One thing I can say about the eyes is that as I use this, if I have a black background, which I have on the most of the baits, as the top of the eye is black or more or less most of it, I will just paint white. If I don't have a black background, I will just start by placing a black dot in the eye socket so I have the appropriate black background for the eye, the center of the eye there. Okay, well, ready to get painting? We're now back in the shed to coat the painted lures. I've made a few preparations. First of all, I'm heating up a larger bowl of soft plastic with no colors in it to use for the coating. Apart from that, I've made this little board with some nails on it, which I use to stick the painted lures onto. I do this and put them in the oven at about 100 degrees Celsius to preheat them a bit. That way I will have a rather thin layer of coating on them. So I'll put them in the oven as soon as I'm nearly ready with the coating. Apart from that, I've just my stuff ready here. Also have a bucket of clean water here. I will place the lures in once the coating is almost dried, when it stopped the dripping from the lure. I don't want the lures in the oven to get too hot, as that will might end up breaking the tail when I dip it. As it gets into the hot soft plastic, the tail gets very weak. So just 100 degrees. And I could just put them on the side, but the painting on these lures at this state doesn't really stick very well. So if you paint them and rub them around, you will simply ruin the paint. So I like to have them standing up like here to avoid the painting scales and so on to be ruined. Okay, well, I'll just heat on and then I'll show you how it's done.
As you can see, I managed to burn the dip to a brown color. As these baits are fairly dark and you only apply a thin layer, it didn't really matter this time. But you should always be careful and heat the dip up very carefully to avoid it getting burned.
Now back here at the brackish waters down by Stege in Denmark to do a little test fishing. Not that I think that the Shad actually needs more testing, as the last three trips with the prototype and also a trip with some of the finished ones have given me a lot of nice pikes. But still, I'd like to do a little bit of a recording to end up the movie, so here we go. With me today I have a box full of shads, and it's nice and sunny weather. Hopefully the wind will go down a bit, but I'm not sure. So if that's true, I will be quite windy today. I made a little poll on my Facebook group, and this was the one getting the most votes for the best color, so I'm trying that today. Apart from that, I guess well, not much else to say. That let's get going. I'll just grab my gear here, and then I'll be going.
Well, the sun is going down here on the last test fishing day. And I'll just use the last light here to sum up the fishing. Not the best day today, but not until here where the sun started to go down has the fish started to wake up, and had a lot of fish following, quite a few takes, and I got a few as well. During the afternoon and evening, I've had 5 fish in the boat, and although it isn't as good as some of the other testing days, I think it's a very nice result. No biggies today, but they are out here. Today it was this color, but well, I don't think it depends on the day. Anyway, I'll just finish up by saying that this one is going to be in my tackle box for many years to come, and I really think that it deserves my approved sign. Well, thank you for watching, and I hope you see me soon.